Steve Cruiser, a PhD candidate in Dr. Tess Moon's Impact Lab in the Department of Mechanical Engineering at the University of Texas at Austin. And we're studying different ways in which protein mechanics can lead to therapeutic intervention. We think of a protein as a three-dimensional combination of secondary structures, each of these secondary structures being represented by the different color struts on this object, we can understand different ways in which mechanical forces can lead to therapeutic interventions. If we take a normal protein under unstretched conditions and we consider its interaction with a small molecule drug, this small molecule drug may not be able to fit into the protein without any changes in shape. However, upon the application of mechanical forces, you may get a shape change of the protein. This shape change may be enough to allow small molecule drugs to interact with the protein and disrupt its behavior. Therefore, mechanical properties of proteins may allow us to target drugs at mechanically regulated or mechanically activated proteins. Think about a protein as a three-dimensional construction of individual secondary structures, each represented by the different color bands on this model. We can understand the value of trying to describe the mechanical behavior of an individual secondary structure. In such events, what we study is how the protein's secondary structure responds to applied loads, so that if I pull on this secondary structure, I can understand the ways in which the secondary structure unfolds. And one of the questions I always get is, when are cells loaded? Perhaps a classic example of this is related to blood flow. We have the example of the heart pumping blood throughout our body. As the heart pumps, it expands and contracts. Each one of those expansions and contractions are stretching the cells inside the heart. Not only are the cells inside of the heart stretching, but also the blood is flowing throughout our body. Now we can feel this blood flow by checking for our own pulse. When you feel your pulse, what you're really feeling is the stretching of the underlying artery as the blood flows past your fingers. Now, if we think about an artery as being lined by cells on the interior, we can understand that with each one of those pulses, each time the artery stretches, those cells that are lining that interior are also forced to stretch. They relax back and then stretch again, much like this demonstration of a cell on the inside of an artery. In this demonstration, we've drawn a cell on the wall of an artery. As the blood pulses past that cell, see an expansion of the cell and a relaxation back to the original size. This expansion is the stretching of the cell and causes a stretching of the proteins inside of that cell.